Projects Tool, Genomic Data Commons, GDC 2.0 Video Guides, Bill Wysocki, PhD, GDC User Services Lead, Center for Translational Data Science, University of Chicago. The GDC Data Portal 2.0 Projects Tool allows users to browse the specific cancer-related projects hosted in the GDC and create cohorts based on their cases. In this GDC video tutorial, we will use the Projects Tool to create a cohort of cases from the TCGA kidney projects that have whole genome sequencing. Starting at the Data Portal homepage, portal.gdc.cancer.gov, the Projects Tool can be reached by clicking on the Projects icon found at the top left of the page, the second icon from the left. The Projects Tool can also be reached from the Analysis Center by finding the Core Tools section in the center of the screen and clicking on the Play button within the Projects tile. Introduction to the Projects Tool page. The large table within the main panel of the tool lists all of the projects in the GDC. Each row represents one project, and the columns contain information about some of the project's properties. The project column contains the project ID, which is formatted as program-project. Note that the program, which is displayed here in the fourth column, is always the word before the first dash. Clicking on the project ID will display a pop-up that displays the project summary page. This includes the dbGaP study accession, the case and file counts by data category and experimental strategy, and a breakdown of the project's data by primary site. The disease type and primary site columns, which are the second and third columns here, display one value if all cases in the project have the same value for the property, and a drop-down menu if the cases have multiple values. For example, all cases in target WT, which is the target Wilms tumor project, have the value complex mixed and stromal neoplasms as the disease type, and the value kidney as the primary site. The cases within the project target NBL, or neuroblastoma, have multiple values for primary site and disease type, which can be viewed by clicking the down arrow next to each value. The cases and files columns display the number of cases and files respectively within the project. Because projects in GDC are expected to have more than one experimental strategy, the experimental strategy column, which is the last column here, lists them out by default. Any column name in the table header with arrows next to it can be used to sort the table by each property. Above the table is the total number of projects in the table, which is 74. Also present are options to export the table in JSON or TSV format, and a search box that can be used to filter by full or partial project IDs. Since we are looking for TCGA projects with kidney cancer cases, we can type TCGA into the field to only show the projects associated with the TCGA program. The total number of projects have been updated to 33 based on the text at the top of the table. We can click on the X to undo this search, as the same filtering option can also be performed in the next section. Filtering for projects. The panels on the left can be used to filter for projects containing each value. First, to filter for TCGA projects, we will use the program card, second from the top, which currently contains all of the programs in the GDC. Clicking the arrow next to the projects label twice sorts the values from greatest to least number of projects represented. Checking the box next to TCGA will only filter projects in the TCGA program. The main table, other filters, and the total number of projects update in real time. The total number of projects is now 33. Filters can be undone by choosing the circular arrow button. The next step is to filter for projects that have kidney cancer cases, which we can do using the top primary site card. Since there are 47 more primary sites, we click the magnifying glass to filter for kidney and choose the box next to that value. There are now a total of 4 projects. For the next step, we filter by projects that have whole genome sequencing data, for which we can use the experimental strategy card, which is the last card from the top. Currently, WGS is not displayed, but we can see it by choosing the 4 more button. Choosing WGS does not change the number of projects, as they all have whole genome sequencing data. This concludes the filtering step, and our last task is to create a cohort. Creating a cohort. Now the main table only contains the projects that meet our criteria. They can be selected one by one by choosing the box on the left side of each row, or they can all be selected by choosing the box in the header. Note that TCGA SARC also has cases with non-kidney primary sites, in addition to cases with kidney primary sites. When one or more projects is chosen, the Save New Cohort box, which was previously grayed out, is now active and displays the number of selected projects. By clicking on the button, a pop-up window will appear, prompting us for a name. To better remember what this cohort is, we will name it TCGA Kidney WGS. Then we click Save and set this as your current cohort. This cohort is now the active cohort and can be seen in the Cohort Toolbar in Query Toolbar. For more information on the GDC Data Portal, please refer to the other videos or go to docs.gdc.cancer.gov.